Welcome back, my dear students, in your English literature class. Hope you all are safe and secure and follow your regular online classes and complete your given works. Today I am here to start and discuss about one chapter, that is chapter 3, trains. And my dear students, as you know, we already discussed about this chapter summary and the exercises, that is understanding text. But now in this chapter and in this class, I will tell you something related about this chapter, and after that I will discuss with you about the understanding test. And so, and after that I will give you one worksheet. You have to complete this, and I will take your online class. In that one time also I will tell you about this chapter and this exercise. So let's start today's class. So my dear students, please open your book, page number 26 and chapter number 3, trains. And so let's get started. Today first we have to recite this poem, and you have to memorize this poem, because if you memorize this poem, when the exam is coming, I will give you this poem. You have to write 8 lines or 4 lines, that time you have to able to write easily. So please memorize this poem, and now let's go start. First, we have to memorize, recite this poem. So, Trains, written by James S. Tippett. So, start over the mountains, over the plains, over the rivers, here come the trains. That is, over the mountains, over the plains, over the rivers, here come the trains. Next, carrying passengers, carrying mail, bringing their precious loads in without fail. Carrying passengers, carrying mail, bringing their precious loads in without fail. Thousands of freight cars all rushing on through day and darkness, through dusk and dawn. Thousands of freight cars all rushing on through day and darkness, through dusk and dawn. Over the mountains, over the plains, over the rivers, here come the trains. Written by James S. Tippett. So in this poem, the trains written by, composed by the James S. Tippett. And it is a beautiful piece in which the poet expresses the usefulness of trains. And a train is a railway wagon with multiple bogies. Here you see that multiple bogies, and in a train, you know that actual train also many multiple bogies. And in this poem, the picture also multiple bogies like this, which is moved by a locomotive engine, and that carries many passengers, mail and cargo from one place to another. So it carries thousands of freight cars, that is why here written thousands of freight cars. And while rushing through the railway tracks from dawn and dusk, there when rails trains are moving, that time they are using the track. So that is why here tell that tracks, thousands of freight cars while rushing through the railway tracks. So it helps the passengers in reaching their destination while crossing many mountains. That is how here it written that mountains, plains and rivers. So let's go discuss about understanding the text. So before understanding the text, we have to know words to know, because if you know the words that is discussed in the poem, if that is increase your vocabulary. And so please read these words to know. So first one is plains. Plains means a large area of flat land with few trees, where a large area of flat land and with few trees, that is called plains. Next, mail, which is called mail, letters and parcels sent by post. By post, through by post, letters and parcels we are sending, that is called mail. Next, precious. Precious means valuable things. Valuable things calls precious. Next, freight. We read in this poem freight card, that means goods card. Goods are called freight. Next, dusk. Evening time. Before evening time, it is called dusk. Next, dawn. Before sunrise. Before sunrise is called dawn. So, let's go now understanding the text. Fill in the words from the poem. The trains go up and down over mountains. Because this mountains word is jumbled in this side, so we have to write clearly, that is mountains. M-O-U-N-T-A-I-N-S. Mountains. Next, the trains are never late. L-A-T-E. Late. The trains are never late. The trains run day and night. The trains run day and night. N-I-G-H-T. Night. Next, answer the following questions. What do the trains move over? What do the trains move over? The trains move over mountains, plains and river. The trains move over the mountains, plains and the rivers. Next, what do they carry? What do they carry? The trains carry passengers and mails. The train carry the passenger and the mails. When do the trains work? When do the trains work? The trains work day to night. The trains work day to night. The trains are never late and work day to night. Do you know any other thing that works like that? Yes, like train, many things are worked. For example, aeroplane, it also works day to night, like train. Next, playing with words. Here instruction that circle the rhyming words in each set. We have to circle the rhyming words in each set. Here, planes, boats, buses, trains. So, which are the two rhyming words? Which are the rhyming word set? That is, first one is planes and next one is trains. First one is plane and next one is trains. Next, please open your book, page number 29. For the reference, here are two numbers is first one mail, then pain, then fail, then river. Which is these two rhyming words? That is mail and fail. That is mail and fail. Next, third number, down, on, wall, draw. Dawn. That is dawn and on. So, let's go the next number, that is find these words with the help of the pictures they end in N. A-I-N. This, we have to see the pictures and we have to write their names and these names are ending with N. A-I-N. So, first one picture is, which one picture it is? It is train's picture. So, we have to write here train. You see, my dear students, that this trains word is end with A-I-N and here also said that A-I-N. So, we have to write these names which is end by N. Next one picture which is two number? Mountain. Yes, mountain. So, we have to write here mountain. M-O-U-N-T-A-I-N.
U N T A I N mountain. Next third number it is plain. Plain. So plain spelling is P L A I N plain. And last one it is rain, because rainy, so we have to write here rain, R A I N rain. Next one we have to do color the sound words in red and movement words in green. We have to here color the sound words with red color and movement words in green. So here we have to select which one is sound words and which is movement words. So first one is bounce, and we have to color sound words with red color and movement words with green color. So first one is bounce. Bounce is movement words. So we have to green this color. And next honk. Honk also the sound words. How honk is a sound word, so you have to did here, put here red color. Next trot. Trot also a sound word, so you have to put here red color. Next quack. Quack also sound words, so you have to put here red color. Clip clop also sound word, you have to put here red color. Next skip. Skip is a movement word, so you have to put here green color. Next TikTok. TikTok is a sound word, so you have to put here red color. Next bleat. Bleat is also a sound word, so you have to put here red color. Next glide. Glide is a movement word, so you have to put here green. And next last one is spin. Spin is a movement word, so you have to put here green color. Next, learning the language. When we talk about more than one person or thing, we add s to the noun. For example, chair, chairs. So let's go to the next page, that is page number 30. Please open your book, page number 30, for the reference. Here instruction they have given that look at the pictures and write the words. We have to see the pictures and we have to write the words. You see that, my dear students, here many books is there. So according to the rule, we have to write here many things, that time books, book, books, many things. So we have to put here s, add here s. Next one picture, how many bags is there? One bag. So we have to write here only bag, B-A-G, bag. Next, how many dolls is there? Two dolls. So according to the rule, we have to write, add here S. So doll, dolls. Because of that, here two dolls. So we have to write here dolls. Next, how many pencils? Many pencils. So we have to write here pencils, P-E-N. C-I-L-S, pencils. Next, trees, three tree is there. So we have to write here trees, T-R-E-E-S, trees. And last one, that is one picture of car. So we have to write here car only, because if here two car, that time we have to add here S, but here one picture of car is there, that is why you have to write car only. Next, when nouns and is in s, h, ch, sh or x, we add es to show more than one. We have to add their es. For example, class, classes. Because the word is end with s, we have to add here es, that is classes. So fill in the blanks with correct words. We have to fill in the blanks. Then one box, many boxes. One box, many boxes. Next, one bench, many benches. One bench, many benches. Only we have to add ES. Next, one glass, many glasses. One glass, many glasses. Last one, one brush, many brushes. One brush, many brushes. Only we have to add ES. Hope, my dear students, you all of you understood today's class. If you have any queries, you ask me in class WhatsApp group and complete your worksheet. Thank you. Bye-bye.